Hi, I'm Brad.
I'm John. Okay, so another one from Reddit History. And this one is entitled 1980s Things That Are Not Socially Acceptable Today.
Yeah, probably everything.
Most everything.
People are too sensitive nowadays.
Yeah, that's probably true.
Too sensitive and too triggered.
Blonde dots!
Yeah, those are probably the 70s. Yeah, probably would have fled into the 80s.
Yeah, could be. Yeah. Still technically not socially acceptable. Although it is socially acceptable to go get drunk and throw axes at anyway.
Yeah. And I play lawn darts at the time, and I never heard of anyone ever getting hurt playing lawn darts.
Well, if you played it properly.
I'd say probably more people got hurt playing on a trampoline than they did, or even swings. I mean, that's how I broke my arm was playing on a swing. No, I was doing what I was supposed to be doing.
But you didn't get your head impaled.
Well, that's because I was smart enough to, oh, look, that dart's coming at me. Let me move.
You use them properly rather than go.
Yeah.
Oh, it's getting bigger.
Okay. Anyway,
little dart rant over.
Yeah. Make sure you hit that like and subscribe before we get going.
Check out the description down below. You can find a link to the video we're about to watch, channel that it came from, which already mentioned, of history. If you hit more in that description, then you can find a whole bunch of other links and information that we have down there as well, because there's quite a lot of it. Okay. Play.
All right.
40 years ago, things were very different. MTV.
40 years ago. I was like 10.
He was just catching on, and Atari was still very popular. We didn't have all the constant news in our face, but our social media was hanging out with friends and family. Some of the things we used to do would probably get you arrested now. Safety standards in cars were pretty well absent. The regulations were more like mild suggestions rather than rules or laws.
Yeah.
Nobody wore seat belts, and many people just wondered why they were even there. As a kid, you could sit in the middle of the bench seat up front and control the radio. If you wanted to see over the tall dash, then you could just simply stand up. Heck, Dad may have even placed you in his lap so you could help him steer the car. It was also common to see kids just packed in the back of a station wagon or maybe in the bed of a pickup truck. Car seats were available for purchase, but rarely would you ever see one in a car. If your car was packed with kids, then it was usually easier just to leave them in the car and then go into the grocery store and shop. Most people just left the windows rolled down and the kids would be just fine.
Yeah. Not even allowed to do that with pets anymore.
How?
It's like, yeah, how many of these things have we done so far? Or haven't done. Been subjected to all of them.
Yeah.
Pretty much. Except for the station wagon thing, because growing up in England, they were very common.
Yeah, we had little cars.
Yeah, we had small cars.
He didn't have big, long.
Yeah.
Big, long cars. Try to get my fingers on the screen. Yeah, just different time.
Yeah.
Kids were very active, and it wasn't uncommon just to tell your parents you were going outside to play, and then you would disappear for most of the day, if not all of it. It was always easy to tell where all the neighborhood kids were just by glancing at someone's yard and seeing the collection of bicycles. If that wasn't seen, then most of the kids would knock on their friend's door to see if they were home and if they wanted to come out and play. If you went around riding bikes, then you certainly didn't wear a helmet. Most people couldn't even see these in stores to buy, and if you could, they wouldn't have even wanted them. Same thing with elbow pads and knee pads. Most kids just thought it was cool to show off your latest injury or skinned knee. If you happen to be too far from home too late, then no problem. Find one of the payphones that were all over the place, and if you didn't have change, then that wasn't a problem either. Your parents knew when they got the collect call.
On the bike thing, the only bike safety thing I ever had was when I was real small. Stabilizers. They used to be a thing back in the day.
Oh, training wheels?
Yeah, training wheels.
Stabilizers. That's what we called them here.
But it's kind of, I don't know, honestly, I don't even see those around too much these days, which is a bit weird. But yeah, beyond that, it was kind of like helmet, no pads. No.
Well, yeah, so they weren't even a thing. At least, well, I mean, I grew up in the 70s. I was a little kid in the 70s. You were a little kid in the 80s. I got a scar on my arm from where I had a Nelgo in my arm when I crashed on my bike.
I got absolutely no scars on me whatsoever when I went through a plate glass window on my big wheel. That's the reason our back door used to have four plate glass big panes, just 1, 2, 3, 4 in it. The bottom one after that was replaced with wood. Because I did. I basically just went the big wheel straight through the bottom pane of wind glass. Didn't hurt myself. Did hurt the door.
Yeah.
Yeah. Payphones. Don't see them much anymore.
You have a collect call from.
I'm at the community center. Do you accept charges?
No.
Your mom and dad would just come and pick you up and load up the bikes if you had them. Otherwise, your parents just expected you to be home by the time the street lights came on.
With us, with the payphones, it was usually, it was, because we didn't call home to let them know. I mean,
yeah.
I don't know, me anyway. It was more like, okay, we're, like, if we were at the, well, not the fair, because my grandma lived at the fair.
Movie theater.
Yeah, like, if we were, like, at somewhere, and we knew that it's like, okay, just call when you're ready to come home. Yeah. So it's like, they already knew where we were, so we would just call and say, collect call from Brad, and they'll just decline, and they're like, okay, they're ready to be picked up. Or you would say, where you want picked up. It's like, at this door or whatever like that. But it was like, they already kind of knew where we were if we were using. Other than that, we just came home whenever we came home, which is usually when they needed an actual ride.
Yeah.
Smoking was still very big, and parents smoked in the home and in the car with kids still in it. Secondhand smoke was just something that everyone had to live with, and most people weren't worried about exposing it to kids. It wasn't uncommon to see people just smoking away in restaurants, and most of them probably didn't even have smoking sections. Things were so different back then that there were cigarette machines in front of some stores and restaurants. No ID check or anything, just insert the quarters and pull the knob. It was also a time when kids would run to the convenience store and pick up some essentials.
Glass bottles.
Yep. Definitely the harder plastic anyway, if they're not glass.
No, it's glass.
Well, yeah. I grew up with the hard plastic ones that, not like the soft things that just kind of shred today.
We had glass or what we have now.
What was I saying? Oh, cigarette machines. Cigarette machines were never a thing I actually saw growing up in England, weirdly enough. Even bars and stuff, they wouldn't have cigarette machines. They'd actually sell cigarettes, and pubs definitely would. They'd actually sell a couple of brands of cigarettes, and usually a couple of nice cigars as well, because, you know, people would go out for a drink and, for some obscure reason, buy cigars while drinking at pubs. They sold surprisingly well. Having, you know, I used to work in a pub restaurant back in the day when I was 18. And, yeah, we actually sold an awful lot of cigars, which was kind of weird. But, yeah. Probably because we just sold them singly.
Yeah.
You didn't have to buy a pack or anything. It's kind of like, oh, I just fancy one.
I remember I told my cousin, because he lived in New York City, and where he lived was busy during the nighttime, had a lot of nightlife, and that was when they started with stopping smoking from inside, so people would be smoking outside. It's like, you need to just walk around with the basket of, you know, individual cigarettes like they do with the roses. I said, I go, I'll just buy them in Colorado and send them to you in New York. They were like a third the price in Colorado than in New York. But apparently there's laws against
there's laws against
he was a lawyer, so it's like, no, I can't do it. That's why there's a stamp on the bottom of the cigarette packs. Because it states what state it's in. So, that was an idea, hey.
Yeah.
So what? Because some people just want one cigarette. They don't want to spend, you know, back then, like, especially in New York City, $10 on a pack.
Yeah.
like, oh, it's, you know, give you $2 for one cigarette.
And that was back then. That's, yeah, you know, we're talking 90s here.
Yeah, no, probably early 2000s. Yeah, late 90s.
I'd say late 90s.
Yeah, I guess so. Mm.
Oh.
Sometimes those essentials were cigarettes, and all we needed was a note from mom or dad and a blank check. Considering how most people were about smoking, it's not surprising that alcohol would be much different. Alcohol wasn't something that kids enjoyed, but I'm sure many tasted it just to see what it was like when parents offered it. Being a latchkey kid...
We actually had... I had a Spuds dog that I was gonna put in the background here, but
couldn't find it.
Well, now it's boxed in there, but I decided not to because I didn't know what YouTube policies.
Oh, that's true.
Were about having it. Yeah. So
kind of not same goes for anything Joe Camel these days.
Yeah, because I have a bunch of Joe Camel stuff too.
But don't you have a bunch of Marlboro stuff as well? Marlboro Man stuff. Yeah. But yeah, you start running into the. Yeah, you're not allowed to advertise that these days.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I did put it back there. Side note.
Being a latchkey kid was perfectly fine. Parents were busy working and doing other things, so it was quite common to see kids at home by themselves or watching younger siblings until they got home. Parents just thought if kids were old enough to dial the important numbers or 911, they were responsible enough to be at home alone.
Actually, go to our other channel. You could get to our store shop link and have a t-shirt that says Latchkey Survivor. So.
Or alternatively, just hit more in the description down below. You'll find
the link. Is it down there on this channel? I guess so. I guess the other channel it's linked here. It's not because
on the other channel,
not a money, whatever.
Yeah.
Channel.
But there is a link to it down below.
Yeah, I forgot about that. Yeah, we didn't even lock our door. Until our house got broke into, then we locked it. Some teenage girls broke in and stole everything.
Well, not everything,
but all my mom's jewelry and stuff.
The massage therapist that was a friend of your mom's. She started locking her door the last 5-10 years since she was home more.
Yeah.
But prior to that, she never locked her door at all.
Yeah.
It's kind of like, well, what do I have to steal? There's a TV there. That's literally the only expensive thing in my house. So.
Yeah.
And it wasn't a new TV. It was a tube TV. It was a large tube TV, which means if you didn't have 15 people to pick it up, you weren't picking it up because it weighed over 300 pounds.
Yeah, exactly. Well, and I think we just grew up in the era where it was like, we didn't lock our door because again, kids are always in school, which is, in fact, how the girls got caught, because
they weren't
in school. The police went to the school and checked to see who was absent, had an unexcused absence that day, and it's like, magically, these three girls who have juvie records already, and then they were dumb enough to show up to school the following, or a couple days later, with some of my mom's jewelry. It's like...
The
police were very cooperative. That now the judge wasn't, because he didn't believe that my mom had that kind of jewelry living in the neighborhood we lived in. It's like, how could you afford jewelry like that? My mom was like, well, most of it was given to me when, you know, from her parents, you know, because it was long, like her high school and her wedding gift. And then her and my dad were married and they had a lot of money when they were married.
Yeah.
They had their own business. And then just, you know, it's like, because you're in the poorhouse now doesn't mean you always were. So, I don't know. Sidetrack.
Okay. Mm. But yes, Latchkey Kid t-shirts available in the store down below in the description. Hit more.
Easily get sidetracked.
Physical punishment was also something that was viewed very differently. Paddling or swats from parents, family, or teachers was considered completely reasonable if the kids misbehaved or were disrespectful. Punishment was usually swift and painful.
Isn't that special?
Peanut allergies certainly were around back then, but kids still brought peanut butter sandwiches and peanut products to school. Peanut and other allergy bans weren't a thing. EpiPens didn't hit the market until 1987, so if you had an allergy, you just had to hope you didn't die.
It was kind of, in a way, Oh, it still is. I mean, yes, EpiPens are a thing now, but it's still kind of a...
Yeah, but you can't take anything that has penis to school now.
But, oh, in most, oh, that's right, in most
schools, they won't allow it.
Here in America.
Yeah.
I was saying about England.
No. Well, it's like, I mean, I understand that people have peanut allergies, but if they're the ones with the peanut allergy, they should be aware to what their surroundings. Why should, you know, if 1% of the population has a thing, why should the rest be punished for it?
Anyway. Mm. True.
My opinion. People might disagree. About fighting in the comments down below.
If you were a teenager in the 1980s, then you didn't have Instagram or Snapchat. Your social media was hanging out at the mall with your friends. You could do a little shopping, eating, and a whole lot of hanging out. Parents would allow their kids to roam the mall by themselves for hours. Kids may still go to the mall today, but not quite as much. If they hang out there all day now, they might accuse you of loitering.
Now, see, we took the bus, and here, there again, I mean, I was young. We took the bus all the way across town to go to the mall.
Yeah. So did I, because I lived in a village, and the mall was, you know, like 15 miles away. So I was taking the bus.
Yeah. Well, when we used to have to do a transfer, we used to have to transfer buses, and it would take you downtown, and where the bus station was, luckily, you did your transfer, wasn't that?
Luckily, I didn't, because the Queensgate Shopping Center... was attached to the bus station, which was attached to the train station. So, yeah.
Oh, there you go.
Literally, the bus... Well, you had the train station. You know, the train station was off to one side, and then the next in was the bus station, which was basically connected by a bridge over the road into the shopping center itself. So, you know.
Well, and I just saw on social media a couple of days ago something, you know, these... Gen Zers, or yeah, I guess probably Gen Zers, kind of making fun, mocking the malls because all the stores are closed and stuff. And I mean, and my first thought is, you know, you're sitting there mocking it and making fun of it, but you'll never understand and ever be able to experience the amount of fun and stuff that we learned and did at the malls, you know. Mm-hmm. And I mean, the amount of jobs that were created with the malls thriving and stuff, and kids going and buying, I mean, or not kids, well, kids, teenagers, you know, young adults. I mean, just the socialization that, you know, had and meeting up with other friends, and just, you know, they'll just, you know, they just, they mock it and make fun of it. And then they'll call us boomers, but I'm not a boomer. I'm a Gen X. So get it straight.
Mm-hmm. And yeah, because boomers were catalog shoppers, just like the current generation is catalog shoppers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, some, it depends.
But of the most...
It was, you know, your younger boomers were getting there.
Well, yeah.
Your silver, well, whatever the other is, they definitely were. But...
I mean, well, I can't say much because actually my mum was still a catalog shopper. I was a catalog shopper growing up in the 80s.
Yeah.
You know, because, yeah, we had the big catalogs would show up and, you know, thumb through them and...
Yeah, that's us.
Circle the things you want to.
This is Christmas about. Catalog.
Yeah.
Which she might mention. We'll see.
Oh, that's true.
I don't remember chicken pot party.
Yeah, neither do I. That was not a thing we did. But... Mm-hmm.
Chicken pox parties were something that many people had long before there was a vaccine. Most people felt it was best just to get chicken pox out of the way so you wouldn't have to worry about it later. If one kid started showing signs, then it was time to gather every other kid who hadn't gotten it for a good old-fashioned party. The PG-13 rating didn't exist until July 1st, 1984, and prior to that, they got away with a lot more. People realized that there was a huge gap between PG and R. If you take a look back at the movie Airplane, which was PG, you'll understand how wide this gap was. The movie was filled with a lot of adult humor in it, and it even showed some nudity. On August 10th, 1984, the action film Red Dawn, starring Patrick Swayze and Charlie Sheen, became the first ever PG-13 movie to be released in theaters.
I knew that. I forgot about that. That was such a great movie.
Mm-hmm. There's an awful lot of movies that have PG ratings that are effectively grandfathered in PG and G-rated movies as well. Because it used to be like a knee-jerk thing for cartoons, for example. Anything animated, you just get, that's You know, yeah, it's a G rated movie. It's kind of like free for all. Anyone can watch it, which is how Watership Down has its rating. There's a movie that's traumatized generations of kids. It's a really good show. If you haven't seen it, you should watch it. It's about bunnies.
Over the last 40 years, there have been many changes, not just in technology, but in regulations on what we can and cannot do. Most of the younger generations do not realize how many changes have taken place during the 80s and have continued to do so. I hope you enjoyed this little walk down memory lane. Thank you so much for watching.
Why don't you come up here, Pumpkin?
What are you doing, Larry?
Well, Vince, I've asked my pumpkin to sit on my lap to prove a point.
And what is that, your Larry-ness?
Even if we fasten our safety belts, even if you hold on tight, even if you were watching the road...
Yeah?
In a crash, your pumpkin will be nothing but a squash.
You could learn a lot from a dummy. Use child safety seats.
We love that little pumpkin to pieces.
Okay, Joey, it's a wrap.
Hi, I'm Joey Lawrence, if you give me a break. After I'm done here, I get a ride home. But the thing is, I will only get into a car with someone who wears their seatbelt. You see, kids like me usually do what the driver does. If they don't buckle, we don't buckle. Sounds pretty dumb, huh? But it happens, just like accidents. Give a kid a break. Buckle up. Your life and theirs is in your hands.
There are some more commercials. We had similar safety commercials, obviously different ones, but we had similar ones. But I was amused by the pumpkin going through the plate glass window.
Yeah, I noticed that too.
It's kind of like, yeah.
They had that in movies too.
I know, but it's like,
that's not how windshields break.
Not from the 70s onwards. Sure, it was the 70s is when that changed, so it's going to... Yeah. But I guess then again in the 80s, you're still going to have a lot of old cars floating around that would, but still, yeah.
I never seen anyone smoke like that, and I'm an ex-smoker.
Tell me, baby, why you smoke that trash?
Why, girl?
Everybody's saying,
what?
You ain't got no class.
Can't you see what you are?
You're a drag,
yes you are.
Dragon lady.
A message for you and me from the American Cancer Society.
Don't be a dragon lady.
I haven't seen that one either. Honestly, I don't actually remember no smoking adverts. Probably because I think cigarette adverts was one of the last things to disappear. No, it was beer was one of the last to disappear in the 80s, 90s in England. Cigarettes were already gone. You couldn't advertise them on TV. So you couldn't tell people not to smoke because you weren't allowed to, you know, show the whole smoking thing.
I don't know when they stopped advertising them here in the US.
Yeah.
I would say it was sometime in the 80s, early 90s. I don't know, because we had the Camel Cash and the Marlboro, the Marlboro thing was.
Were you just Marlboro Bucks or something?
Yeah.
Was it Camel Buck?
These are just old commercials, or was that it?
Yeah. Oh, that was the last one.
That was the last one. Well, that was interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Good old memories.
Yeah. And
and they were good memories, too. Yeah, such a good time back then. And, I don't know.
And you can't do these anymore commercials.
Yeah.
Can't smoke. I suppose I didn't have a drinking one. That wasn't really 80s, though. More 90s.
Yeah, and the seatbelts. Yeah, I remember that became a big thing. I think I have that picture posted on the Instagram when I was in the wreck at Pizza.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Because I almost, in the description down below.
Yeah, I think it. So I remember I was wearing my seatbelt, but it was like I had just started wearing it. I never, because I actually got a ticket. Well, I didn't get a ticket. I got a warning beforehand because I didn't wear it, and it was like something that they were just starting. So
that would have been.
Yeah. So. As John yawns, which makes me yawn now. So, well, with all that being said and watched, we're definitely going to hit this guy's channel up some more. So, if you want to see any of those, make sure you hit that like and subscribe.
Leave comments or suggestions down below. Hit the notification bell. That way you'll know when we do the suggestions you left in the comments.
And until next time, thanks for watching.